Well, I'm a happy lad. Everton won, Man United won at Old Trafford. Welcome to Falcon Blues TV. A game there we didn't deserve to lose. Definitely didn't. Today we were exceptional. Couple of little tweaks here and there, but given the collective side that we've got out there today, given the number of injuries, number of players out, that was just superb. That was excellent to watch. Alan and Doucouré just linking up so well in that midfield, and hopefully long they may that continue because that was excellent from the pair of them. Anthony Gordon was exceptional until he went off. And just an all round great performance from Everton. And the full credit again goes to the two new signings, Damari Gray and Ross Townsend. Now I'm not getting ahead of myself, I'm not getting over the top, but today was just it's something we just wanted to see from an Everton side for so long, and we're finally getting to see it. The just hard work, running, not giving the opposition time on the ball. We were that first half, the chances that we had there in the first half where we could have had two, we could have had a couple ourselves. Townsend misses that one, and then Rondon has a chance. It was just, a lot of it was just hitting the ball straight at their defence, unfortunately, and we paid the price toward the end of the first half. But I think again with the personnel that we had, I think if we'd have had players in who were who are regulars, Calvert-Lewin, Coleman, Richarlison, those players are going to make the difference in this side, and they're going to make a difference after the international break. So this is great to see that we've got a team there that is starting to gel together and just be a unit rather than a team of individuals, and that's something we've lacked for so long. Excuse me. And we got the reward today. I think really we didn't deserve to go into that first half one at the end of the first half 1-0 down. It took a wicked deflection, but if you listen to BT Sport, sorry, Man U TV, yeah, no, sorry, it was BT Sport. You'd have thought that it didn't even take a deflection from Martial's shot. It took a wicked deflection off Ben Godfrey and went past Pickford, who was again exceptional. I think Pickford kept us in it for large portions of the game there, especially the first half where there was chances going in. After Martial scored, there was still chances going towards Pickford. There was a save from Cavani in, I think, after about 15, 20 minutes. Just again, proper, and then just an all round. I can't stop saying it was an all round great performance from Everton, and to see it at Old Trafford is so refreshing. Just I'm over the moon with that. As I said on a Man U podcast the other day when I was on with them, that I said 2-2. And Yerry Mina puts the ball in the net. It was offside by Tom Davis, didn't shoot, or at least just have a go with the near post. I don't know, but that's another story for another day. We'll probably rue that chance of not taking the 3 points from United, but to come away with that, I'm buzzing. I said a score draw, 1-1. That's fine. Just to come back from 1-0 down as well, where it looked like, okay, second half they're gonna really come at us now. And with all honesty, they didn't, which surprised me. I thought United were. I think they almost thought that it was above them, the game was above them, and that they could have done. I will just shut this out whenever we need to. And similar with Ronaldo, who just seemed to come on and just try and referee the game. He has a go over the goal from Damari, sorry, Andros Townsend, from that run from Damari Gray. The work ethic on Damari Gray to get the ball back to win it and run, make that run for Townsend was exceptional. And then Ronaldo's on the 18-yard box screaming at everyone. I know it came from a corner, but so you got every right to give him a bit of a bollocking. But let's not take away from Damari Gray and Andros Townsend there, because that was just superb. And Townsend's celebration to take the piss out of Ronaldo was even better. So, but I think Everton, we've got our just desserts there. We've deserved something from this game at least, and I'm over the moon with that. Next home game now, and next game's West Ham, I think, isn't it? And then the international break. So hopefully we can get someone like maybe Calvert-Lewin or Richarlison back in the side, just to give us that bit more. Freshen us up a little bit and give us a bit more firepower up front. Because for all Solomon Rondon's, he worked hard, he linked up well with Gray, but today just again wasn't his day, and he just looks still very, very sluggish and very unfit But I think we just need to put bodies in places at the minute. But if it's square pegs and round holes, then we've got a bit of a problem. But hopefully, with players coming back, that'll sort it out. And it was nice to see Lewis Dobbin getting on the pitch for the last couple of minutes as well. He didn't have to do anything. He just had to just make a nuisance and just run. And just if he got the ball, keep it. And that kid's time's going to come as well. And the same with Ellis Sims. Because looking at that bench today, wow. I mean, Gbamo was back in, but then, Charlie Whittaker and two goalies again. Tom Davis, Lewis Dobbin, Ellis Sims didn't make it because I think he was injured in another video or whatever from what I saw earlier in the week. But overall, yeah, I'm happy. I'm sure you'll be happy as well. And I'm going to take a lot of positives out of that. And you're going to look at me and go, it's going to pain me to say it, but well done, Benitez. I think he's come out and set a game plan there, and it's worked. And hopefully that's making us difficult to beat and making us difficult to break down. And I'll finish this up because I'm just buzzing with that. I'm made up. I think we could have won the game, which is just probably a slight on the team. But other than that, excellent, Everton. Let's keep it going. Absolutely brilliant. So let me know what you think in the comments. Give us your thoughts below. Please make sure you're liking and subscribing to the channel. We all appreciate that all the time. Till then, up the fucking toffees. Colin Chong. Happy days. I love Andros Townsend.